Welcome back to module 6 of the second chapter of Elements of Set Theory. And we will be talking about some specific examples in this module. Now what we have done is in the last two modules, module 4 and module 5, we have talked about the various identities in this chapter involving the operations, union, intersection and complement and the difference of sets. And we have seen how to prove those identities or any result in general by using Venn diagram and then by using basic definitions. So let us look at some specific examples in this module. Let's say I have a universal set that is U containing the alphabets from A to N. Set A is defined as A, C, D, J. Set B is this, B, D, E, H, K, N, and set C. Now here we are talking about specific sets, some particular sets here. This A, B, C are coming from this universal set U. Now the question is, or suppose I want to prove or check whether A minus B is equal to A intersection B complement. Now this is something that we already proved in general, so obviously it will be true. But then, given specific sets like this, what we'll have to do is we'll have to find out A minus B and then A intersection B complement, and then we'll have to see whether both the sets match or no. So if I have to find out the left hand side here, let's say the left hand side is A minus B. Okay, so given this A and B, what will be A minus B? By definition, A minus B is the collection of all those elements of A which are not in B. Now which are the elements of A which are not in B? Okay, A is one element. A is in A but not in B, so it will come in A minus B. Then C is also not there, so this C will also come in A minus B. Then D is present in B, so that won't appear. And J, J is also not in B. So A, C, J are the elements of A which are not in B. So they will come in A minus B. So this is our left hand side. Now let us look at the right hand side. Now so first I'll have to find out B complement. So what is B complement? Now I have B here. B complement is the elements of universal set which are not in B. So which are the elements which are not in B? So A is not there, A, B, then B is there, C is not there, D is there, E, then F is not there, F, G is also not there. So we are looking at the universal set here, and those elements which are not in B, we are writing in B complement. So A, C, F, G, then H is there, I is not there, J is not there, K is there, L is also not there, M is there, N is not there. So this is B complement, the elements which are not in B, the elements of the universal set U which are not in B. The same way we will find out A intersection B complement. So finally I'll be finding out A intersection B complement. Now B complement is already here and A is here. So I have to find out intersection. What is intersection? The elements which are common in A and B complement. So I look at A and I look at B complement. So I have to look at which are the elements which are common in A and B complement. So A intersection B complement. So A is a common element. A is in both the sets. So A is in intersection. C is also there. So C is common element. Now D is not in B complement, so it is not a common element. J is present in both the sets A and B complement, so it is in the intersection. There are no other elements in A, so there won't be any other element which are common in A and B complement. So I get A, C, J, and it will check that the left hand side A minus B, A, C, J is same as the right hand side A into section B of U1. So for this specific sets, we have proved that A minus B is therefore A minus B is equal to A intersection B complement for this set. In fact, it's true for any sets A and B. So given some specific sets like this, this is how you prove those results. The same sets, let me consider the universal set A, B, C. So I have the universal set here U and the sets A, B, C coming from this universal set. Let us say I want to prove the De Morgan's law, one of the De Morgan's law. We have already done it using Venn diagram and the general definitions. Okay, let us do it for this particular sets as well. So what I'll have to do is find out the left hand side, that is A union B complement, for which you first find out A union B. Now what is union? You are combining A and B together. So all those elements which are either in A or B will appear in this set. So A is there, B is there, here, then C is here, then D is here, then E is here, then E, then E, F, G, H is here, H, I, J is in A, so it will come here, J, then K is here, in B, so it will come here, then L is not there, M is here, and that is all. So these are all the elements. I'm writing these elements in order so that it is easier to look out and find out in case I have missed any alphabets. Otherwise, if I have to combine A and B, I could have just straight away written down A, C, D, J, B, D, E, H, K, M. But then while I write like this in order, I can easily check how I have written the sets and in case I have missed any elements. That's why I'm writing it this way. Okay? Of course, not a rule that you have to write it that way. So this is A union B. I want A union B complement. So I want complement of this set. What is complement? The elements which are not here. So which are the elements which are not here compared to the universal set? A, B, C, D, E, F is not here. F, G, H is there, I is not there, I, J, K, L is not here, L, M, and then N is not here. So F, G, I, L, N are the elements which are not in A union B, that's why they are in the complement. This is our left hand side. Now let us look at right hand side. So for that I'll first find out A complement. I need A complement. What will be A complement? The elements which are not in A. Which are the elements which are not in A? B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J is there, so it won't come here. So rest all K, L, M, N. So I have A complement. The elements which are not in A are the elements which are in complement. So all those elements I have written here. The same way I write down B complement. Okay. What will be B complement? The elements which are not in B. Which are the elements which are not in B? A, C, then F is not there. F, G, I, J, L, M is there, and N. A, C, F, G, I, J, L, N. These are the elements which are not in B. So they are in B complement. So finally, let me write down A complement intersection B complement. Okay, that is the right hand side. Okay, A complement intersection B complement. And what is intersection? The elements which are common in the two sets, A complement and B complement. Which are the elements which are common in these two sets? Okay. So B is not common, E is not common, F is common, F, G is common, G, H is not common, I is common, I, then J is not common, K is also not common, then L, L is common, and N is common. So F, G, I, L, N, these are the elements which are common. F, G, I, L, N, N. F, G, I, L, N. These are the only elements which are common. Okay. Now you compare it to the left hand side. This is the right hand side. F, G, I, L, N. F, G, I, L, N. Both are same. So you are concluding that A union B complement is same as A complement intersection B complement for these two particular sets. Okay, so we have verified De Morgan's law for this pair of sets. Let us say we consider the other De Morgan's law and we want to prove that for this example. Okay. So the same way I'll have to find out the left hand side and the right hand side. So let us start with the left hand side. To find out the left hand side, first I'll have to find out A intersection B. Now what is A intersection B? The elements which are common in A and B. Now what are the elements which are common in A and B? A is not common, C is not common, D is common, only D is common, J is not common. So D is the only element which is common in A and B. So next we find out A intersection B complement. So what will be the complement? All the elements which are not here. Now D is the only element which is here. So rest all will be in the complement. So A, B, C, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N. Except for D, I have written all the alphabets. Okay, so this is my left hand side A intersection B complement. Let us find out the right hand side. So first you will find out A complement. What will be A complement? The elements which are not in A. The elements which are not in A are B, E, F, G, H, I, K, L, M, N. Except for A, C, D, J, I have written all the elements. The same way I write down B complement. What will be B complement? The elements which are not in B. The elements which are not in B are A. A is not here. B is there. C. Then D, E. Then F. G. H is there. I. J. K is there. L. M is there. And N. These are the elements which are not in B. So finally, then I find out A complement union B complement. So A complement union B complement. So I have to combine both these sets now. I'm taking union. So all those elements I have to write down here. Okay. So A is there in one of the set. B is there. C is there. D is not there. E is there. F is there. G is there. H is there. I is there. J is there, then K is there, L is there, M is there, and N is there. So every element which is in either A complement or B complement will appear in its union. Okay, and now this is our right hand side. So compare this right hand side with our left hand side, and you will see that A, B, C, E, F. A, B, C, E, F, G, H, I, J, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, K, L, M, N. Except for D, all the elements are here. Same like how I have here. So, we have proved that A intersection B complement is equal to A complement union B complement. Okay, so the next example. Suppose I have considered the same universal set and I have considered the same sets A, B and C here. Let us say I want to prove this result for these sets A, B and C. Okay, now I have three sets all included in this result. So the same way I will find out the left hand side first. Now to find out the left hand side, you will first find out A minus B. What is A minus B? The elements of A which are not in B. Which are the elements of A which are not in B? A, C, and J. This is something that we have already written before. A, C, J are not in B. A is not there, C is not there, and J is not there, D is there. So B, D is there, so that's why it is not appearing here in A minus B. This is A minus B. And now you want A minus B intersection with C. What is C? C is here. So I have to take A minus B, this set, intersection with C. What is intersection? The elements which are common. So which are the elements which are common in A minus B and C? A is common. A is the only element which is common. C is not there. And J is also not there. So A is the only element which is common. So this is our left hand side. The same way now we look at the right hand side. Now to find out the right hand side, first we will find out A intersection C. A intersection C. What is A intersection C? The elements which are common in A and C. Now which are the elements which are common in A and C? It is A is common, C is not common, B is common, and J is not common. So A and D are the only elements which are common in A and C. The same way we find out B intersection C. What is B intersection C? The elements which are common in B and C. So I have B here, I have C here. Which are the elements which are common? B is common, D is common, E is not common, H is common, H and H, K is not common, M is common, M and M, so M. B, D, H, M. So finally, we find out A intersection C minus B intersection C. So I'm looking at A intersection C minus B intersection C. So what, by definition, what are we looking at? The elements of A intersection C, that is this, which are not here. So which are the elements A and D which are not here? A is the only element, D is present here. So A is the only element which is not there. So this is our set that we are looking at. So this is our right hand side. Okay, and we compare with the left hand side, it is the same set that we have got here. Okay, so we have proved that A minus B intersection C is same as A intersection C minus B intersection C for this set of sets. Let us consider another example. Okay, the same sets, the same universal set, the same sets A, B, C, and let us say this is what we want to answer. The question is A minus B minus C same as A minus B minus C? So the same way, we'll find out the left hand side set, we'll find out the right hand side set, we'll compare both of them and we'll see if they are both same. So let us first find out left hand side. For that, first A minus B. What is A minus B? The elements of A which are not in B. Okay, and that is A, C and J. D is there. Okay, so A, C, J is A minus B. And now A minus B minus C. What will this mean? I have to look at A minus B minus C. So the elements of A minus B which are not in C. Which are the elements? So out of A, C, J, which are the ones which are not here? A is there, C is not there, and J is also not there. So out of A, C, J, C and J are the only ones which are not here. A is there. So C, J will appear in A minus B minus C. Now let us look at the right hand side. So for that, first let us find out B minus C. What is B minus C? The elements of B which are not in C. Which are the elements of B which are not in C? B is there, D is there, E is there, E is not there. So E, H is also there, K is not there, so K, and M is there, so E and K. E and K are the only elements of B which are not in C. So finally, then we'll find out the right hand side. So what will be A minus B minus C? So I'm looking at A minus B minus C is here. So by definition, these are the elements of A which are not in B minus C. So which are the elements of A which are not in B minus C? A is not here, C is not here, D is also not here, and J is also not here. A, C, D, J, all these four elements are not here, right? So they will all appear in A minus B minus C. This is our right hand side, and this was our left hand side. Okay. Now compare left hand side, it is C, J, set containing C, J, whereas right hand side is A, C, D, J. Now they are not both the same sets. Okay. So we'll conclude that A minus B minus C is not equal to A minus B minus C for these three sets A, B, C that are given to us. So given some sets, specific sets like this, this is how you'll be verifying the results that are given to you or whatever question that appears in this one. Thank you.